Peace be with you. I would like to tell you something about love and obedience in connection with the Holy Spirit. There is only one test of love, and that is obedience. By obedience, Jesus showed his love of God, and by our own obedience, we must show our love of Jesus. This is predicated on the fact that the expression of love is not sentiment or emotions. Rather, it is morality revealed in obedience. In the world of today, many claim to love but bring pain and heartbreak. Children towards parents, husband and wives, fiancés and fiancées towards each other. But unfortunately, by their inconsiderateness, their irritability, their thoughtless unkindness causes grief to themselves. To Jesus, therefore, real love is not an easy thing. It is shown only in true obedience by the guidance of the Holy Spirit. No wonder he promised these great and unspeakable blessings to us, which is his Holy Spirit. A paracletos, that is someone called to help in time of trouble or need. This is a great New Testament promise, as that of the Messiah was of the Old Testament. And just as the Jews could not recognize the Messiah, so also the world cannot recognize the Holy Spirit. By the world is meant that section of men that live as if there was no God. The point here is this: we can see only that which we are fitted to see. Just as an astronomer sees beyond the sky, a botanist beyond hedgerow, an artist beyond pictures, musicians beyond symphony, so the faithful can see beyond the world. And so we can conclude that the Holy Spirit is paradox to the sinners, but axioms to the saints. The Holy Spirit, therefore, gate crashes no man's heart. He waits to be received, as light in the air, as sap in the tree, as soul in the body, and his communion with us is intimate, his union is inseparable. Let us wait to receive him during the Pentecost.